So today our guest is my good old friend, Mr. G.K. Mahantesh, who's the managing trustee of Samarthanam. But today he is here as the president of the World Blind Cricket and the chairperson of CABI, which is the Cricket Association for the Blind in India. And he will be talking cricket. Last week, we had Mr. Ramchandra Guha, who was also speaking about cricket and the history of Indian cricket. So today, we will be hearing about, and there were a lot of questions about blind cricket last week, and that's why we thought we would invite Mahantesh to come and take a session today. So, so Mahantesh, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jad sir, for that lovely introduction. Hi friends, good evening everybody. It is my privilege and honor to be a part of this fantastic platform, and I have been always mentored by George sir, I can say from 1989-90, ever since blind cricket became a movement in India, and the dream of hosting the first nationals in 1990 was decided. From then, I have been having the luxury of getting his mentorship, guidance, and he has been a great source of inspiration to me and a role model. For me, cricket is a life from childhood. Like many, I grew up listening to radio commentary in late 70s and early 80s, starting from India winning the World Cup in England and India hosting the Reliance World Cup in 1987, so on and so forth. But me, along with a lot of my friends in the blind school where I studied, Sri Ramana Maharshi Academy for the Blind, that's where I met George first in 1989 or early 19, possible, like many of you, cork ball, powder tins, oil tins. Tremendous passion always kept me very active. And I continued to stay in the school. Even after I finished my academics in that school, I studied college, staying in the same hostel. So cricket continued. I think that was a good fortune. So 1990, I still remember that nostalgic memory of being a player in the first nationals, playing in Delhi winter. And subsequently, till 94, I played, and I had the good fortune of being part of organizing the World Cup, first World Cup in Delhi and second World Cup in Chennai under George Sir's leadership. In 2010, George Sir felt that I should, along with my friends, Nagesh and team in Samarthanam, should take over and manage blind cricket. I would like to extend big thanks to you, sir, for trusting us and believing in our capability, giving us this chance to take the game forward. But all that what we learned from you helped us to build CABI. So Cricket Association for the Blind in India, from 2010, last 10 years, is managing, governing, and fostering the game of cricket for the blind, with a clear vision of motivating visually impaired to play the game of cricket, inspiring them, building aspirations in them, and asking them, this game can give you something which you wouldn't have imagined. We believe in creating that spirit of dreaming in them, not only dreaming big, to play for a team, for their state, and also for their country. Our strong vision is to create a strong Indian team. Consistently, they remain as world-class team and can beat any team, including Pakistan and others. That has been our constant vision. And providing the suitable training, providing a fitness coaching, and also creating a career opportunities for them is our prime focus. In the last 10 years, CABI has consistently been a winner. We hosted and won the first T20 World Cup in 2012. Prior to that, after Jhar sir handed over the responsibility, we sent a team to England and beat them. It was a whitewash. And also, we were invited to the AGM of World Blind Cricket in Dubai in 2011 and got the hosting rights of first T20 World Cup. My friend Nagesh, I should remember him now. Unfortunately, we lost him 4 years ago. He was a great source of support and strength to me personally and to the blind cricket and to the movement. We lost him. But in 2011, when we were discussing about hosting the first T20 World Cup, it was he who made me raise my hand and bid for it. So that started our journey with a lot of challenges, trials and tribulations. We successfully hosted. Under the able leadership of the chief of selection committee, whose responsibility was only to pick the best players, which will win the World Cup for us. For our good fortune, we won the first World Cup, T20 World Cup, and continued winning in fourth ODI at Cape Town, Asia Championship at Kochi, and second T20 World Cup in 2017, and also fifth ODI at the historic Sharjah Cricket Ground in 2018, and many bilaterals and triangle series. So Cabby has in the game, not only in India, at a global level. Last year, our team went to teach and coach the Jamaican cricket team. So like this, Cabby's vision for game became a competition with us. Just to give you an example of women cricket, which we hosted last year, which was a long-term dream of many of us, which was hosted in Delhi with a very good cricket facilities. When we announced, there were only three teams, mostly three states had girl cricketers, but it turned out to have seven teams. A couple of team states flew their girls to Delhi, and a good hotel accommodation was provided, buffet meals were served. A lot of this was first time for many girls, if not for all. Most of the girls were excited. I could see their excitement. So Cabby continued to create this vision to inspire more players, both men and women, and also youngsters, small children, school tournaments we have organized. So just to conclude with regards to vision is to create a continuous winning team, providing best of the facilities to them. Could be cricket gears, facilities, a lot of things. And just to talk about Cabby's growth, I already gave you a snapshot working this game, taking a lot of tips from the mainstream cricket, men's cricket mostly, and also men's cricket. We have engaged the services of many professional experts who are managing the mainstream cricket, administrative skills, and also standardizing a lot of things. We started naming our friend Nagesh the national tournament on him from 2018. So first national tournament on a Ranji Trophy model was started in 2018, dividing the teams according to their capacity, their performance, and all that. So first one was in 2018, and the second was in 2019. Just to talk about the recent one, we standardized a lot of things. A lot of aspects were incorporated, providing standardized clothing, providing uniform shoes, and hosting the games in a good cricket facilities, standardized accommodation with a standardized food. Everything was structured, and also neutral umpires is introduced in state level itself. Sorry, in the national level itself. So the growth has been consistent, and if not rapid, year on year, we are seeing a lot of changes. A lot of people who are involved in managing the cabbie are themselves visually impaired, and the professionals are helping us in bringing their expertise. Just to talk about the second national tournament, most matches were live streamed for the first time, 4-star accommodation, and Wales was live telecast in Doordarshan. So like this, many important aspects are brought in, and we are constantly getting support from few companies. It's helping us to dream big, think big, and do big for our cricketers. Our cricketers always remain focused for us, so which has helped us to provide a sufficient support system for them. And we have also introduced match fee for every match they play from domestic tournament itself. The difference between has been dreaming big, as they said. We have started engaging many hikas. So we have engaged a professional management school, which has helped, which has come forward to help us identify what we are doing is in the right direction, how we should be doing all that. We have commissioned an impact study to guide our team.